Hello friends, now we see the number 3 function that fx is equal to tan x of chapter differentiation. Since fx is equal to tan x, therefore the next step is f of x plus h is equal to tan in bracket x plus h. Then by first principle of derivative, we have f dash x is equal to limit h tends to 0 f of x plus h minus fx upon h, that equal to limit h tends to 0 for f of x plus h, we write tan of x plus h minus tan x whole thing divided by h. The next step is limit h tends to 0. Now tan theta is equal to sin theta upon cos theta. So therefore tan of x plus h can be written as sin of x plus h upon cos of x plus h minus tan x, we write sin x upon cos x, and then whole thing divided by h. So that equal to limit h tends to 0. In the numerator we go for cross multiply. So on cross multiplying we get sin of x plus h into cos x minus cos of x plus h into sin x, and then whole thing divided by cos of x plus h into cos x and into h. So now the numerator is trigo formula that sin a into cos b minus cos a into sin b, so that equal to sin of a minus b. So present case x plus h represent a and x represent b. So the next step will be limit h tends to 0 sin in bracket x plus h minus x and whole thing divided by cos of x plus h into cos x into h. So that equal to limit h tends to 0. Now here we plus x minus x cancel, so we left with sin h in the numerator, and to get rule we take h from denominator, so this is as a one limit, and then whole thing divided by limit h tends to 0 cos of x plus h bracket complete into cos x in the denominator. So that equal to, now limit h tends to 0 sin h upon h, that gives 1 upon cos in bracket x plus 0 and into cos x. So that is equal to 1 upon cos x into cos x, so that gives cos square x, and Trigo formula 1 upon cos theta means sec theta, therefore 1 upon cos square x is equal to sec square x. So in this way we prove f dash x is equal to sec square x. It means the derivative of tan x is sec square x. So this is a required solution for the given function fx. Thank you.